So over this lunch, you no doubt found out about the unique history of this place and why it's so special in Provence. So let's go back to, was it 1966? George Brunet. From Chateau Lagune, he came to Provence and he was determined to make a Bordeaux-style wine in Provence.
Yeah.
Everybody laughed.
Yeah.
You foolish man!
Yeah, yeah.
Those
and
great
he bought this in his farm, and he had to clear the forest, and he had to break the stone, and he planted first only Cabernet Sauvignon.
Which Cabernet Sauvignon in Provence? No.
No.
Sillard, Grenache, yes, Cabernet Sauvignon? No.
And he actually got it approved in the AOC, and so he's the reason Cabernet Sauvignon is permitted in Provence today, in the way you do. And then he made the...
So he grafted his Bordeaux grapes
and
brought them down there.
So it was actually from La Lagune.
Yeah.
And actually the first vintage we still have, and it's excellent.
Yeah.
It's fantastic. And everyone saw, he's making good wine in Provence.
Yeah.
And this was because of his abilities, and it's also because of the terroir.
Yeah.
And the secret is, we are at 400 meters high above the sea. We have two mountain ranges protecting us from the sea. We have Saint Victoire and we have the local one in front. And this makes this place having a microclimate, and therefore the terroir and the climate makes it possible to do very good wine with acid and with the right level of ripeness. We harvest almost as late as normal, and therefore you can make quality wine here. And this is more and more seen, because we have a neighbor, Chateau Vignelaure, we have another neighbor, Pierre, who is also Béatier, who's making great wines in this area.
And the idea was to age the wine like fine Bordeaux is aged, and Provencal wines, maybe you accept Bandol a little bit from that, didn't really have a reputation for aging like 5 to 10 years. But here, and we're going to go down into the cellars to see. There are vintages dating back to the 1970s.
Yes, yeah. And they're just aging better and better. Really.
But we should say, when we bought it, you know, we didn't know about history.
Yeah, I mean, listen.
Because we found out, it, of course, the previous owners told us about quality, and we can taste them, and we could taste a good wine, and also the big lines of the story, but we didn't understand
the reputation
and veneration.
Yeah.
Before we kind of got into it. So when we bought, we started being alive because we wanted to, as owners, to go up and meet some of the top restaurants in the Provence.
That must have been a hardship.
We thought now we have to go out and really sell our wine. And when we came, there was so much love, so much respect, and so many memories around Vignelaure, and we were received as, you know, because we bought Vignelaure and we wanted to take it further.
Magnum, and we do particularly many magnum in order both for restaurants to have and to keep, and the quality is even better in magnum than in normal bottles.
This is where we understood,
this
is not a Provence dream, maybe it is, but this is a business, and we have to be clever and competent and work hard.
So have you devoted a lot more time than you expected to Vignelaure?
We were so lucky with Philippe, he could run the daily operation, so we are, our method mostly is in the marketing and the strategy and the thinking of all. The big decisions, of course, we do that when we said we go organic.
Yeah.
Philippe said, it's a lot of work, it's an old vineyard, it can be difficult to go organic. We were reasoning, which is in between.
Yeah.
And when we said, we are doing white wine, and he said, we're not doing this for you, we do it for your kids, because it will take 20 years before it's a good one. But, so we pushed the big decisions.
Yeah.
Met the strategy and the marketing, and Philippe do the work, and it's a fantastic combination, and this works very well.
So we're going to head on down another level. It goes down 5 levels, I think.
This is also from one of our wine collections, the last exhibitions, because sometimes we do also paintings or photography. So this
who became a friend, Jose Nicolas, a French guy, traveling the world to difficult places.
Yes.
Yeah. And documenting that as a war photographer. Then there's
Passarelli.
Yeah, Passarelli. Different pieces of Passarelli.
He's a Passarelli. Right?
That you also see on auctions often. And then for photography lovers, this is this is special stuff. Yeah.
Johnny, our cameraman, uses the same camera as Monsieur.
So this is Chateau Poisson, and again, this is dedications which go through the whole collection. Dedications for George Brunet. Qui a bu voir. So once you have tasted the Chateau Vignelaure, you will keep drinking.
Lovely phrase for the boy, delivering the bottles, maybe.
And so these are originals from the time, and digging into art and photography, it's all about originals.
That's not lovely.
It is.
I think he's drinking beer there. It looks like he appreciates me.
He's a happy man.
Yeah.
He's having a conversation.
Yeah.
This is a Danish artist, Robert Jacobsen, that we brought here because we like the idea that he is famous international. He's also sold exhibition on auction. We like the idea that this piece had been exposed at the Musée Rodin in Paris. And this one, being art people, you shouldn't really do this, but this is a Buffet, who is very, very, very expensive on auction in the world. And this is not the original, because if it was the original,
we would be standing on the
And it was changed by one of the owners after Brunet, because there were some financial problems.
Yeah.
Then the original Buffet was sold. And a copy was put up.
Right.
And of course, you shouldn't really have copies on your wall, but we think that it's a story about life.
It tells a story of the place.
That's also how life is. It goes up and it goes down. And it was quite original as a solution.
Yeah.
And then we brought a few pieces to the collection down here, but otherwise, we wanted to keep it as it was. Sorry, this is a Swedish street art artist that you know. In Calais, we like colors, and we have very colorful design and art in our interior decoration. And so we took this down for a big exhibition, and also we did in Scandinavia. That's all. And here you have another also very well-known
César,
the
king of compression.
Yes, exactly. So you know, and
it's a holiday.
It's a holiday.
From Paris, yes. Another place.
It's always unbelievable.
And it's always unbelievable, as you say, what he does. And you have this funny story about César that somebody brought a Rolls Royce. Somebody who loved his Rolls Royce, and he said, could you make an art piece of my Rolls? And he said, yes, and he tried, but he didn't manage because Rolls Royce was too
too sturdy, so the press could scrape.
And he got it back, but
I can't make a piece of art.
It was the Rolls Royce, it wasn't his heart.
And then I could just finish up maybe with this one. This is a French artist, and we bought it because that was also one of our summer exhibitions. And at that time, our little son, he was about five, our big son, he was about 5 years old, and he came around with us to see all the art. And when he saw this, he came, we did a tour, he said to everybody, this is my mother and my father.
we have to buy that.
We have to have this. Yeah. So,
that's fantastic. And you come down here a lot to look at the words?
We do. We come a lot, but always with people.
Yeah.
We never take a stroll ourselves, but since we have a lot of groups and a lot of tours around.